How often have we been filled with anger and rage at people who have hurt us and holding on to that and clinging to those things that are just so hurtful to our past? We're mad at people and get that anger going on inside, or a coldness going on inside of us. And the Lord wants us to be free of that. That's a tomb. That's a grave. Because we're not free to be at peace. We're not free to live as God has created us to be. The Lord wants to call us forth. He's saying to us, come forth. Be unbound. Be free. This mission this week, we are going to discuss the various ways that God calls us to that freedom. Tomorrow night, 7 p.m., we're going to gather here and we're going to talk about God the Father. We're going to talk about how God the Father has adopted us and what it means to call God Father. We're not going to discuss who God is to us, although that's a good thing to know. It's more important for us to understand who we are to God. Who I am to Him. What do I matter to God? Because so many of us believe that God loves everybody.
Except me.
God loves everybody, like the Pope, but really not me. God loves people like Mother Teresa, but not me. And somehow we exempt ourselves from the love of God. We're going to see tomorrow evening how that is just simply not true. And how understanding who we are to God, how that will free us from the fear, free us from the shame. It'll change the way we look at life. It'll change the way we look at struggles and difficulties, change the way we understand suffering, and even change the way we see death. We know God the Father, who we are as His children, and the reality, the revelation of the fact that we have been adopted by God, what that really means, it will change our perspective on life and dispel the shadow of despair, the shadow of shame, the shadow of depression, the shadow of fear, just shadows. Nothing real to it, just shadows when we stand in the light of the Father. On the second night of the mission, we're going to talk about forgiveness. Tuesday night, 7 o'clock, we're going to talk about not being forgiven so much as forgiving others. You know, the Our Father prayer, forgive us our trespasses as we forgive. Ouch. Had to throw that as word in there, huh? What does it mean to forgive? How do we forgive? When do we know we have forgiven? How do I get free of the revenge? How do I get free of the pain? How do I get free of that, all that I'm carrying from what was done to me? How do I forgive those who have hurt me in my past? What does it mean to forgive? How do I know when I have forgiven? We're going to discuss all those issues. And we'll discuss forgiveness of God and the mercy of God, and we'll give you an opportunity for confession. We'll have a few priests here to hear confessions. And we're running a special. Anyone who's been away from the sacrament 25 years or more is half price. So we hope you make it. But surely a time of mercy, a time to be forgiven, and a time to forgive. On the last night of the mission, we're going to discuss your patron, St. Joseph, the man closest to God. There was never a man closer to God than St. Joseph. And we're going to discuss how St. Joseph really is the model of Christianity, the model of what it means to be a Christian, what it means to love God. We're going to discuss how he can teach us how to live as free sons and daughters of God, to live in that trustful surrender to the Lord. How St. Joseph is such an incredible example for us, a model for us, and such an amazing intercessor for us. I got a few good stories of St. Joseph and beer, so we'll see about that. That's a little teaser for it. So I encourage you this week to come out to the mission. Take the retreat. Shut off the TV, the iPod, shut off the radio, the computer, whatever else is out there, whatever the gadgets are going on. And take the time to retreat before Easter. Take the time away to really prepare for Easter by rediscovering who we are to God. That God doesn't just love us, but that God is in love with us. Someone can love you, but when someone's in love with you, it makes a big difference. To discover that God is in love with us. To discover His mercy, and then how to be merciful. See St. Joseph as the incredible patron and model that he is. So please come Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, 7 o'clock to the mission, so we may be able to enter deeply into this. And this isn't just for the elderly. This isn't the mission for those 75 and over. They're welcome. But it's also for those under 75. If you can understand the words that I'm saying right now, then it's for you too. For the young adults, for the middle-aged, for the more than middle-aged, for the teenagers and those younger young people. Children, you'll all benefit from it, I'm sure, as we reflect together on the powerful reality of being part of a great and awesome, incredible family of God, and discover the fullness of who we are to Him, and who we are to each other in this family of ours. May the Lord lead us into the depths of the wisdom and knowledge of God, the depths of the meaning and understanding of His love, that we might live free. May God bless you, and Mary keep you. Thank you.